So back in the day, researchers determined that the Earth's rotation was slowing down a bit. And in order to keep our atomic time accurate, they decided that sometimes one extra second needed to be added to our clocks. This is known as the leap second. The leap second was added 27 times in history, but every time a leap second was added to our clocks, it caused utter chaos in the programming world, breaking some major networks. And what is more interesting than learning how one little second can cause such huge mess-ups in the technical industry? Since 1972, there have been 27 extra seconds, leap seconds, that have been added to the world's common clock, which is called the Coordinated Universal Time, or better known as UTC. And the most common question here is, why do we even need to add an extra second? Historically, time was defined based on a solar day. A solar day is a period of time in which the Earth makes one complete revolution on its axis relative to the sun. But because the Earth's spin is somewhat irregular, because of tides, tremors, Scrum Master causing you to stress eat, the Earth may spin slower or sometimes faster. And this results in our solar time and our universal time drifting apart. So at the time, if we didn't add leap seconds, there would be issues with things like space and satellite navigation. If you take something like satellite navigation, it relies on precise location. And precise location relies on precise time. And we know if the positioning of satellites become messed up, a lot of things fall, like GPS navigation, network and communications, etc. So because of this, the concept of a leap second was created. The group, called the International Earth Rotation and Reference System Service, actually decides when this leap second should be added to our clocks. And it's generally done on the last day of June, June 30th, or the last day of December, New Year's Eve, which is December 31st. And every time this little leap second was added, many developers around the world had a bad day. If you don't know how to code or you're new to programming, it's important to understand that many developers have been victimized by time. Not the verb, the noun. Time is always present and it's always important in most projects that you do, if not all. Computers also rely on time. They use a service called the Network Time Protocol, or NTP, which also checks the computer's time against a more accurate server, which can be connected to an external source of time, like an atomic clock. Why? Because a computer also finds time important, especially if it needs to do specific tasks at a precise time. Many applications need to perform tasks at specific times, even across different systems. But time itself isn't so easy. There's different time formats, calculations, different time zones, different methods. If you were a programmer 30 years ago, dealing with time was a pain. If you're a programmer now, it's still a pain. Maybe it's less of a pain because there are newer methods to deal with issues related to time, but it still can get very complicated. So we know that dealing with time isn't very easy to do. And developers also know when there is an event that happens that is very rare and very infrequent, that event will often cause the system to behave in a completely different way than normal. And now you can see how something like a leap second would cause chaos. One, it's based on time, and two, it's a rare event. The year was 2012. The date was the 30th of June. And yes, you probably know where I'm going with this. That naughty, naughty group called the International Earth Rotation and Reference System Service made the decision to add a leap second on that day. And in the early morning, Reddit was down. The company posted on their Twitter account, "We are having some technical difficulties at the moment, investigating. The system administrators at the time thought that it was due to a network slowdown. They thought that since Amazon went down the day before, a network problem made sense. However, the administrators started digging and they eventually traced the problem to a group of their machines running on the Linux operating system. Their servers were working on overdrive and not completing many or any tasks. Now, the problem was traced to a glitch in the Linux kernel, which is the core of the operating system. And the issue was with something called the HR timer, or the high resolution timer. This is a really precise timer that can measure very small units of time. The HR timer issue happened because of how the leap second was handled by the Linux operating system. Chances are, with a big tech company like Reddit, even at the time, multiple processes would be running at the same time. And on June 30th, 2022, an extra second was added. This means that the clock showed 23:59:59, then 23:59:60, and finally 00:00:00. And the high resolution timer in the Linux kernel got confused by the extra second. It just wasn't designed to handle time going from 59 to 60 seconds. This confusion caused some systems to keep running the time check process over and over very quickly. Basically, it resulted in a sky-high CPU usage and a huge drop in performance. In fact, Hetzner AG, which is a large data center operator, actually sent a message to their customers on the same day. They admitted that this leap second bug actually caused their electrical power consumption to increase by 1 megawatt. 1 megawatt is about 5,000 solar panels. It's a large amount of energy. A lot of companies were affected, from LinkedIn to Mozilla to Yelp. And in 2015, another leap second was added. And the same thing happened. Twitter experienced problems with estimating how long ago tweets were sent. There were also major websites like Instagram, Pinterest, Netflix, and Amazon that went down for about 40 minutes. Again, all of these were time related. If you've noticed, Google, which is probably the biggest web company, they didn't really seem to have any issues related to the leap second. They were always up and running. They posted this blog, and it actually detailed how they dealt with the leap second. In a nutshell, what Google did was, instead of adding the leap second all at once during midnight, Google spread the addition of the leap second over a period of time. Google modified their network time protocol servers, and what they did was they made these servers gradually add a couple of milliseconds to each time update they sent out, starting well before the actual leap second occurs. By the time the actual leap second was supposed to be added, Google's internal clocks have already accounted for it through these small incremental adjustments. And Google used a specific mathematical formula to make these adjustments smooth and prevent any unfavorable behavior from happening in their systems. So get ready for some good old-fashioned mathematics. And don't call me a nerd because you're watching a video on leap seconds. So first thing that anyone would think is Google knows that one extra second needs to be added, but they're actually choosing to manually add this 1 second gradually as the day goes on, instead of just adding this one leap second at the end of the day, which will confuse the system. So why not just take 1 second and divide it by 86,400, which is the number of seconds in a day, and get that value, and then add that constant value to every second on June the 30th. So by the end of the day, the amount of seconds they add would actually total up to 1 second. So the problem with this is the distribution of load. A constant adjustment rate would mean that the same load is applied all the time throughout the day. At the beginning of the day, at the end of the day, the same distribution would be applied, which I think in general are critical times, especially since the end of the day marks the deadline in which the leap second needs to be added. So what they want to do is ensure that the adjustments they added are gradual at the beginning of the day and are gradual at the end of the day, so the system gets a lighter load on critical timeframes. So ideally, they're looking at small increments that look like this. Now, if you know mathematics, this represents a wave function, and that's why they chose the cosine function. Cosine functions oscillate between -1 and 1 and look like this. T represents the time elapsed and W represents the window. So for this example, our window would be 24 hours or 86,400 seconds. And if you just had to plot a normal cosine function, it would look like this. So Google was planning on adding minor adjustments to their time within 24 hours. And all of these adjustments must add to 1 second. So they needed to add 1 second cumulatively, starting from 0, ending at 1. Pretty simple. A plain cosine function, well, that starts at 1 and ends at -1. So what they did was multiply that cosine function by -1. And when you do that, you're actually reflecting the chart along the x-axis. So now the function, which looks like this, starts at -1 and ends at 1. But again, Google needs it to start at zero and end at one. Well, they changed the equation and they just shifted the graph up one. Now the chart looks like this, and it starts at zero, which is good, but it ends at two. So they divided the equation by two, and this is the main function that they used. It started at zero at the beginning of the day, and at the end of the day, it just added 1 second cumulatively. And with this, you can actually see the change is quite gradual at the beginning of the day and at the end of the day. So that's one solution of handling leap seconds. And Google has tried it out and it's worked very well. But the other solution is a lot of companies are just saying to completely scrap the leap second. So this blog post by Meta was actually posted by their engineering team, and Meta is basically saying that leap seconds suck. They're saying leap seconds cause a lot of disruption in the tech industry, which we know, and in the blog post they explicitly state, while the leap second might have been an acceptable solution in 1972, when it made both the scientific community and the telecom industry happy, these days UTC is equally bad for both digital applications and scientists who often choose TAI or UT1 instead. Basically, they're saying most modern companies don't even use UTC. Interestingly, researchers and scientists who specialize in time and frequency are also agreeing. But they are mainly agreeing that leap seconds don't need to be added because the Earth is actually spinning faster. So if anything, a negative leap second would be more accurate. This was noted by the BIPM, which is an organization that ensures global uniformity in measurements and timekeeping. However, I'm sure that many tech companies won't be happy about a negative leap second as well. But at the moment, it seems like we're not adding another second to our clocks just yet. Can this be changed? Of course. But if it does, at least you know that adding one extra second is actually quite a big deal. Thank you so much for watching. I've always found this concept of leap seconds so fascinating, and the solution to deal with that was pretty cool. If you like my content, please like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you on the next one.